the National Library of the Year. Do you know why?
Books.
Books. Any monkey can own a bunch of books. This library is about way more than books.
I'm just looking for the...
Bring on the clowns.
No.
Well, it's here if you ever need it.
The Kalamazoo Public Library. Activities, DVDs, local history, MP3 players, and oh yeah, books.
Just imagine access to thousands of years of human thought and creativity. Generations of information for the entire community inside a dazzling new building in downtown Kalamazoo. Discover the whole wide world at the new Kalamazoo Public Library. Opening celebration April 18th.
You need big anchor things that are central to the community in the downtown area.
We wanted the library to take its place along with those other institutions. We wanted to have people understand how art could be part of the process.
The Electra Lear, that's an example. The rainbows on the wall are an example of a really interesting collaborations between artists, artisans, and architects.
If we are creating a library, which we enjoy doing very much, for a community, we assume that there should be a uniquely appropriate library for that community. And our job is to find out what is uniquely appropriate. We ended up doing 5 buildings at once, none of which bear any resemblance to the other.
As you move through the city and you come upon it, I think it's a building that makes you want to stop and see exactly what it is.
A college student came in one day and I asked if I could help her, and she said no. She said, I was just walking past the building and I had to come inside and see what this wonderful building was. She just had been drawn in. She saw the outside of the building, had never been in here, had no reason to be in here except that she had to find out what was inside because it was so compelling.
They wanted an architecture that would actually market library services through design, which was a very exciting concept for us. We find that librarians are wonderful resources because they have the pulse of the community.
It's so much fun to watch somebody come in who hasn't been here before, because they walk in and they go, oh, and they walk over to the rotunda area and they look up and their eyes just get all big, especially if it's a sunny day.
You walk in and it just really takes your breath away. It's so beautiful, it's so exciting.
What I love the most is when the sun comes out. It gives you a brightness about coming to work. It really enhances your spirit about being here. Different people come in that didn't used to come in, and it's just a whole new experience. Every day is a whole new experience working here.
We got an awful lot of positives from the staff because the ambiance for the staff as well as the public is good. Plus, there were really good designs into the staff areas.
Under our guidance, our leadership, we dealt with the building design, the landscaping, the interior design, signage for the buildings, and in some cases, we actually custom designed the furniture.
Oh, I love it. I just love it. I had never seen a more amazing looking library. I've never been in as beautiful a library.
Now, they're using it as a place to congregate. And so I think that the impact is that people have a better understanding of what a library resource can be for them, because the place is exciting to come to. It's now a destination for a lot of family and individual activities.
I think one of the strengths that people really like with small children, the children's room has some wonderful artwork in it, and children are drawn to it, and it's very, very childlike.
By the time school's out, kids hit the library and they're grappling with each other to sign up to be the next one on the computer.
As far as we know, we were the first library in the United States to run fiber wire all the way to the workstation. There's a growing rift between the haves and have-nots with computer access. And we are not in a wealthy community. And this library really does serve as a bridge between the haves and the have-nots. And that's an important issue, because it does help people.
Of course, all the technological changes have been good. That provides two different things for people: a really beautiful, peaceful environment where you can come and study and read and look things up,
And also, it's a really exciting place to come to. It kind of gives you a sense of the future and possibilities and that you can really accomplish anything.
Actually, David and David's firm was fun to work with. We worked on 5 buildings with him. And we got to really enjoy working not just with David, but his staff, Seth and Dan Whistler primarily, but Tamsin and others, you know, as well. And I think we just built a nice friendship.
All of our architectural design work is collaborative. My key associates in the office work together very closely. I totally depend on them for what we accomplish. We are collaborative with our clients, and we're collaborative with citizens in the communities in which we work.
We spend a good deal of time at community meetings, showing them some ideas about what was possible, asking them what they wanted from a library. And we're able to use that information and the guidance that David provided as the architect in developing those plans and developing the way the community could understand the role of a public library.
We've spent a lot of time thinking about what makes a successful public building, and we've concluded that the elements might be termed the 3 P's, that is, presence, a sense of place, and progression. To us, this means that a building with presence is one that is popular. It ends up on postcards, and people like sending them to their friends. Successful buildings also have a sense of place, where you're delighted to arrive, you want to stay, you're reluctant to leave, and you make plans to return and bring your friends. And finally, progression, a successful building leads the visitor naturally through the building with a series of events and images with a minimal need of signage.
Kalamazoo is a very cultural community. We wanted the library to take its place along with those other institutions. We were guided in this notion by the suggestion that David made to bring in Michael Hayden to incorporate art within the architectural process so that we had it going on from the beginning.
Michael Hayden is a wonderfully talented artist, an artist in light, and not only did he teach us how to create lighting effects with holographic materials, but he created some genuine art objects for the library. So we have Michael both creating art for our libraries and teaching us how to make our buildings more artistic. It was a wonderful collaboration. The buildings themselves were very different in size. The smallest was a 4,000 square foot renovation of an existing library in a community center for an African American neighborhood. And in that library, we actually had a tapestry woven in Ghana as a central piece of art. And then we took colors from the tapestry and worked it into the rest of the interior design scheme.
I think they feel completely comfortable here. It's bright, it's sunny, there's color everywhere, and I think that really brings out their joy.
At the Eastwood branch, it was a new building in a residential neighborhood, and so it was important that the building nestle in and be good neighbors with the houses along the street. The building is identified by its cupola at the top. It shows rainbow iridescence. The front door is surrounded with holographic glass, translucent glass developed by Michael Hayden.
The day I was there, it was a beautiful sunny day, and the rainbows and the color that plays off of the walls and the texture and in all the furnishings and the books itself were just wonderful. It really touched your soul, I think. It made you want to just sit down and stay.
The Washington Square Library is a renovation. The building was built in 1929 in the style of English arts and crafts architecture. It had lost its luster. While using contemporary materials and fabrics, we attempted to recreate the feel of English architecture from the 1870s. Michael Hayden developed these wall sconces. Above each of the 2 fireplaces are tile panels that have been specially created for the library. The carpet in this building was chosen because of its resemblance to parquet flooring.
Actually, I think it's the total package altogether, the restoration, the way that it was done with keeping the woodwork and adding the wallpaper and going back to a restoration period kind of light. So I think that it's the package that they're happy with.
The Ashtamo Branch Library is an unusual new building. The staff told us that the library served families and children, and would we please make sure the library was fun, fun with a capital F. We came up with an idea of what if we recreated a Camelot image, a castle-like motif, and we presented that concept in model form to the library, and they broke out in chuckles and never asked us to consider any other option.
It's really interesting. It really drives you to kind of stop in and say, I wonder what this place looks like. I mean, how is it set up on the inside?
We happened to pass this library, and she was just enthused by the castle look from outside, so we had to come in.
Well, I love the building. Nice, light, bright space.
Marvelous. They have more area for the kids to sit down and read books, as I'm finding their books. As you can see, we give them a lot of business.
What I most like is that moment where you realize that it not only will work, can be afforded, but it can have an impact, an emotional impact on those who live there or visit there or work there. And it's something that we could be proud of as sort of contributing to the vocabulary of architecture. When that moment comes, it is the real joy of practicing architecture.
When we were coming towards the completion of the construction of this building, there was a desire to celebrate.
For the opening, which I think was attended by over 1,200 people, which is maybe not a record, but certainly a much higher level than usually attends a function like that. The continuing and overwhelming response was almost disbelief.
Actually, the newspaper summed it up real well the next day. They had a special section, and they headed it Beyond Words. They had a picture of the outside of the building, and their heading was Beyond Words. People were just extraordinarily enthusiastic, and actually, they've remained enthusiastic about the building. I don't know the last time this community had a party of that nature.